China's supercarrier type 003 Fujian, Chinese are inexperienced in carrier operations. Launching of China's third aircraft carrier, the type 003 Fujian is a different beast. 10 meters longer than her predecessors, it is likely to be the largest non-American aircraft carrier in the world. China's first carrier was a repurposed Soviet ship, and its second was built in China but based upon a Soviet design. Both were built to employ a so-called ski jump launch method for aircraft, with a ramp at the end of the short runway to help planes take off. Even better, China directly jumped from the short takeoff but arrested recovery, STOBAR, system to the electromagnetic launch system, EMALS. EMALS functions on powerful magnetic fields generated by electromagnetic induction motors to propel lighter objects, use fewer resources and recharge faster. Unlike the steam-powered catapult-assisted takeoff but arrested recovery, CATABAR, launch systems on the older generation of US aircraft carriers before the Gerald R. Ford class. CATABARs can launch fully armed and loaded jets and even heavier early warning aircraft without depending on helicopters with limited range. Experts assume China's fourth carrier to be nuclear-powered, allowing it to stay out at sea longer and carry more fuel, cargo, artillery, and aircraft, because of the space created with the loss of a large gas turbine. In fact, the development of Type 004 with a nuclear installation and even greater displacement is already underway. In 2017, it seems that the cutting of metal and the installation of heavy cranes for the construction of the ship's hull began. Even experimental nuclear reactors on salt melts were tested in 2020. PLA Navy with a total of 4 aircraft carriers in service by 2030s. The carrier can even better protect itself from airborne threats when combined with regular weapons, possibly reducing the load on escorting destroyers and frigates. A Global Times report said it would get an improved version of the J-15 heavy fighter compatible with a catapult launch, another electronic warfare version of the same jet, a stealth fighter called the J-31, and a fixed-wing U-aircraft called the KJ-600. But this also means that China is far from mastering the complex carrier operations that the US, British, French and Indian navies have taken decades to perfect. There are various departments in a carrier ranging from aviation to the engine room, air defense, logistics, meteorology, etc. Getting all of them to work in tandem is one thing. It is a whole other to get them to sail with other surface assets like destroyers, frigates, and fleet replenishment tankers in diverse sea conditions. Chinese are undoubtedly working hard to catch up. Still, they know they are far from the sheer experience Western navies have, said Commodore G. Prakash, REIT, a former naval aviator.
Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.